There's three, four, they're everywhere!
What's it like for you guys to know that people are gonna watch this movie and wish your death upon you?
What? Katie, out now.
This that is was rude and uncalled
Where's
for.
Where's our publicist?
I think people like us.
I think they will too.
I don't know.
I think people will hopefully be rooting for us, our demise, that is, because we're funny and dumb people, and their audience is probably saying, What are you guys doing? Run away from the storm. Why are you guys going into the goddamn thing? Why are you drinking beer and filming stupid things?
No, we get to play a bunch of idiots, so it was not a stretch.
No, okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
And for you guys, what was the, what is the scariest thing you've ever forced yourself to do?
Scariest
Go with the
thing.
PG thing on this one.
I have a feeling some R-rated ones have been
really. Yeah, is this unrated?
It is unrated. You should go fucking
well,
crazy.
Well, honestly,
you gotta tell us that beforehand. Oh,
she said .com.
Oh, HitFix.
We're gonna say whatever we want.
Com.
Yeah, it's internets.
Go ahead, Jonathan.
Well, I would say the scariest thing that I forced myself to do. Well, I'm a stand-up comic, so the first time on stage was very, very scary.
That's what
to say. And I didn't get many laughs. I mean, people laughed at me for sucking so hard, but I count that as laughter. So I went back.
It counts.
Yeah, I was like, let me switch it the other way.
You did a Chevy Chase pratfall.
Yeah, I thought it'd be funny to fall down. But to my own credit, the fall is so good that people didn't laugh. They felt sorry for me. So they were like, oh no, it's his first time and he fell. I was like, no, I did it on purpose. Shit. And I had the microphone way over here. No one could hear what I was saying. Yeah. The only person laughing is actually my buddy Marty, who's in the back room taping me. Mm-hmm. And if you watch the tape, I'll tell a joke, no one laughs, and the camera goes.
Bless you, Marty.
It's my first found footage film.
I lived in Arizona for a while. There's this place there called Grasshopper Point where it's a cliff so you can jump off into the water. And I was already jumping off pretty high, but getting a little junky, a little smoking some weed. This is in my youth. I'm an old man now. But they said, dude, do a flip off there. You'll be fine. So I did a flip, landed straight on my belly, and knocked the wind out of myself, and my whole chest, everything was bruised, including Mr. Hoo-Hoo.
Mr. Hoo-Ha? So, well, this guy is a daredevil.
I used to be.
It made perfect sense for him to be in play this part, because you are a daredevil.
I used to be a skateboarder most of my life.
When did that stop? When did the daredevil?
It all stopped when I tore my ACL and my knee. It also all stopped when I was beat up by 7 dudes and got my face smashed in and blind in my left eye.
Okay. That's where you just draw the line.
I was a bad kid. I did a lot of drugs growing up and a lot of bad things and fights. And then after I got beat up, it really did change my whole life. Stopped doing drugs, started being nice.
And now look at him.
You ready? Dun, dun,
dun, the more you know. He actually is got a lot of dead body parts in him.
I do. Couldn't know. I swear to God. I'm like that. There's a movie about that guy.
No, what do you have in your neck?
Well, dead cadaver vertebrae. So also have cadaver ligaments. And I've had 3 eye surgeries, so I have a dead person's cornea in me.
Oh my gosh. He's literally the walking dead.
I was about to say, which is scarier, zombies or a tornado?
Tornado.
Yes.
Yes.
Unless it's me.
Tornado's real.
Unless it's me walking at you naked.
I was supposed to say, are you part zombie scary. Then?
I really am. That's why me and Sarah Wayne Callie's here. I've been chasing around set.
Yeah. Sarah. Come back here, sir. Those are my peanuts. Put them down. Yes.
For breaking entertainment news and more, follow @HitFix on Twitter or visit HitFix.com.